New Mexico PBS has once again partnered this year with the other PBS stations in the state to bring you coverage of some of the biggest races in the upcoming midterm elections. You can head to our website at newmexicopbs.org to see our candidate conversations with the U.S. Senate and gubernatorial candidates, as well as our first congressional district candidate forum. And tune in next Thursday night at 7 o'clock as we sit down with the candidates in the 3rd congressional district. Right now, we want to dive into some of the other statewide races. Let's start with the race for state land commissioner. We'll see how far we get. In a recent Albuquerque Journal poll, this race was a tight one. Only 2 points separate Democrat Stephanie Garcia Richards and Republican Pat Lyons. And also in the race is Libertarian Michael Lucero, of course. And Eric, an important race for a lot of reasons, with the winner in charge of more than 14,000 square miles of trust land in the leasing of, as you know, we know about. What's your sense of the race as it's sitting now? Is that 2-point margin surprising to you? Because Pat Lyons is a name that's been out there for quite a long time.
Well, you know, we're working on, you know, Working Families is working on this race, so to disclose that. I mean, but I will say I know a lot about the race, and I think the biggest development is the fact that Chevron just kicked in $2 million to support Pat Lyons, and that's just astronomical. Nothing has ever been that magnitude, even in a governor's race.
Right, that's right.
So, you know, Stephanie Garcia Richard is an interesting candidate. We've never had a woman land commissioner. Mm-hmm. We've certainly never had a Hispanic woman land commissioner, but we've never had someone who's sort of an educator who doesn't come sort of from this land background. You know, right. What Pat Lyons is saying to everybody is, you know, I'm a rancher, I know this stuff, this is not my first rodeo. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think that probably plays pretty well in rural New Mexico. They want somebody who really understands land use. Mm-hmm. But that office has really taken on such a different role. It's really, as we all know, it's where we get a huge chunk of our funding for education, for healthcare, for a lot of our sort of basic sort of government functions that most people support. Mm-hmm. So I think it's going to ultimately come down to a lot of things that are going to affect all these other down ticket races, which is will things like the Kavanaugh hearing really mobilize women, for example? Are women from the top of the ticket on down really going to see a bump from all this? Mm-hmm. Has it really energized the Republican base? Has it energized, for example, some rural voters, some much
Fair
more
enough.
Conservative voters?
That's right.
But anyway, I think it is the one race that I believe it's the closest statewide race that I think the Republicans and oil and gas in particular thinks they have the best shot of winning.
Mm-hmm. Sophie, what do you think of that?
Oh, I agree. The fact that it's a 2-point difference and the margin of error is 4+, something like that. Now, Garcia Richards is slightly above, slightly higher than Pat Lyons is. And given his name recognition, given the fact that he's been in the position before, I would expect him to be doing better than her and not just sort of at that dead heat. I mean, this is a position that does, as Eric said, traditionally go to ranch folk. And Garcia Richard is a very different type of candidate. Mm-hmm. So it'll be interesting to see what happens there.
Is there a blue wave possibility for Stephanie Garcia Richards here versus Pat Lyons? Is that enough?
I think there is possibility, and there are a lot of unknowns. I'll say I don't think people realize how important this race is necessarily and how important the policy issues that run through that office are. One big issue, the land commissioner won't have that much of a say in it, but the idea of whether or not we're going to go raid the permanent fund,
yes,
especially in a year when we have such a huge surplus from oil and gas, is really important, and everybody should be talking about it.
Right.
I personally am very opposed to it. The other interesting thing about this race to me is it shows how thin a Republican bench we have. I mean, we are seeing the same perennial candidates, and you know, I want to see some fresh blood on that side of the aisle and some new thinking, some new ideas. I think people are ready to see some new candidates.
Some new ideas about land management itself, are you saying as well? You know, new ideas from the Republican Party about how we actually do this? Or?
Well, sure. And there's no question that Pat Lyons is experienced in this area and he's held the job. I just, you know, I think we need to be able to field additional candidates. Mm-hmm. And that's true for the AG's race. I hope we have a chance to talk about that. Mm-hmm. These should be competitive races with new ideas, energizing people in the Republican Party. And I don't really see that happening.
I'm glad that you mentioned, Justine, that you mentioned early child and the permanent fund, because that's how the race is very much being talked about. It's not to the point about how much is this conservation and land use. The conversation I've seen online hasn't been about who's going to do X with public lands. It's actually been about, even Pat Lyons' ads have been about who's going to really protect the spending for education. And I do think that's a big difference between them. Stephanie has said we need to invest some of that permanent fund, a reasonable, sustainable amount. Mm-hmm. Pat Lyons is basically not talking about it.
That's not true.
He hasn't said the permanent fund. He opposes it, right?
He says he's opposed.
Yeah, it's good. So that's important for people to know, right? Sure. Should you invest in the in early childhood? Should you?
I think it's also important for candidates to talk about something they can actually have input on. Mm-hmm. Nobody cares what the land commissioner thinks about investing the permanent fund. They got nothing to say about it. Mm-hmm. What they have to say about is who gets access to the land, what the rules and regulations are going to be about, whether we're going to generate money, whether we're not going to generate money, right, whether we're going to close down public lands, whether we're going to leave public lands open, whether we're going to have a harmonious relationship between farmers, ranchers, and wilderness folks. I got to say this, the lady that's running Stephanie Garcia Richards, I don't even know who she is. Mm-hmm. Pat Lyons is everywhere. Pat Lyons has had the job before. You know, the one Republican in New Mexico, I agree with Justine, we got to get a deeper bench. We have to get a bench. Before mm-hmm. we even talk about the depth on the bench, we got to get a sub. But I think the one Republican that any Democrat would kind of, think twice about having to run against is Pat Lyons. He's done it before. I mean, beat a land commissioner that no one thought could be beaten, period. Mm-hmm. I do think it's important for this race, though, because this race is so much about setting policy for what you're going to do to generate revenue for the permanent fund. It's not a place, in my opinion, to set policy for activism or for deciding that we're going to have social causes. The job of the state land commissioner is to maximize the use of public lands to generate revenue for the permanent fund. Then the policymakers decide what to do with it. Mm-hmm. And he has a proven record of doing a good job at it.
Actually, I think he's got a kind of a sketchy record.
Thank you. That's where I was intending.
If you look at the news reports, Google it. Soliciting from folks who are current leases. I mean, that's just like a no-no, and there's been an ethics complaint filed on that, and I think that's going to come back to haunt him. The fact that he actually has, and the AG investigated it, Pat Lyons, I like the guy personally. I think he's a good, nice guy, mm-hmm. and he might be a great face for some Republican.
I don't think the AG has investigated him. The auditor did a
state
report.
Auditor.
Actually, the state AG investigated him on White Peaks, and
that was
whether
the previous.
Yeah, it
right.
was the previous. By the way, that was right. when he was around. So
that's right.
I really encourage voters to look at his background because he may be a nice guy, but mm-hmm. he's got for someone who is in charge of, to your point, in charge of a lot of money.
Right.
I think he's got some real issues.
Get a little tight on time. So we know what Eric made mention that letter that was sent out asking for support and for money.
Sure.
From lessees, and there's some question whether that is
and
actually.
And to be clear what a lessee mm-hmm. is, I'll
please.
Just put on my,
absolutely.
Yeah, my little hat. Mm-hmm. These are individuals who are currently leasing land mm-hmm. from the state for various purposes, I think largely ranching, and he mm-hmm. basically took a list of those individuals and sent a mailing to them right. asking for money. Yep. Now he says, oh, well, it wasn't a very successful ask. I didn't get very much money out of it. But regardless,
that's not the point, right.
he took mm-hmm. a list of people leasing money from the state, and that's he right. will have a say-so as to who leases going forward as right. those leases come up. So,
but true for every statewide office.
But would you anticipate the legislature looking at that, though?
There's no, something about because here's that. The thing. If you're going to tell him, uh-huh. which, look, as a candidate, I probably wouldn't have mailed those people. I can see
sure.
how it doesn't look good. But we got to talk on the other side, right? So if you're running on the other side, you're going to be able to go to the environmentalist groups and raise money who actually want you to do the exact opposite.
Right.
So if we're going to criticize someone who's leasing the land, then why are we not going to criticize the folks that are going to come in with their specific pointed policy and benefit their organization mm-hmm. from your actions? No one's criticizing the money being raised on that
yeah,
side.
And these we're are the people to, most interested mm-hmm. in the outcome.
That's true.
And they should be.
I think it's worth noting, too, though, that there is a statute that says, for instance, the PRC can't do that. But there is no statute here.
Got to go. Sorry, guys. Great subjects all the time we have. Now, make sure to go to our Facebook page where the line panelists mark the passing of State Representative Larry Larrañaga, who served our state very well for many years. Thank you all for being here. We'll see you next time.